burdock over here. We'll point out a couple stages of burdock. So, the easiest way to find a burdock plant is to look for this. So if anybody has dogs, they probably found this stuff. So those are the burrs, right? They stick on you. They're just literally sticking to my finger right now. You don't even need to, you know, you beware, don't get them in your hair because you might have to cut them out. So anyway, there's a burdock. So this is the seed. Again, didn't list the seed here, but you can open these up. You can eat the seed, you can sprout it, you make little burdock microgreens. There's something, you know, if you want to get into something really cool is harvesting wild seeds and growing wild microgreens. I would suggest that the nutrient level of wild microgreens is even going to be leaps and bounds above domesticated microgreens of your standard things that you would find, you know, buying microgreens. But anyway, it takes a little bit of effort. You got to cut it up and they're in there. And again, separate seed from chaff. But you know, there's something, again, you just, there's those seeds. So you can harvest a whole bunch. Like, look at them all right there. Just on, that's a relatively small burdock plant too. Again, these things can get huge and really bushy and, you know, get all sorts of seed from it and chop that up. And, you know, really what nutrients are in that seed, I really don't know. But I would love to know, you know, if we had the, you know, funding or equipment or whatever is required to analyze the nutrients in this seed, I would suggest that there's a lot going on in here. And, you know, again, grew right there. Nobody planted that, I'm sure. And there it grew. And so if you're looking for the root, so, you know, I particularly singled out burdock root because that's kind of the famous part of the burdock. Again, you're going to find that in all of the herbal medicinal books. Hugely medicinal. It's very similar to sort of the red clover. This alternative term you see under the actions is really sort of a common denominator between all of these different plants, which I found very quite interesting. There seems to be some correlation between nutrient density and this alternative action of altering our inner landscape for the better. So burdock, again, very cleansing. Burdock root for the whole internal system that's, you know, just really helping to bring that body back into alignment, help move out those toxins, you know, super nutritious, really breaking through that, you know, hard congestion that most of us have these days. And, but, okay, so there you go, you know, huge amounts of nutrients there. An interesting one I guess I'll talk about now is that inulin there. I listed sort of at the top of the nutrients. Inulin is, what do they call it? A prebiotic. So you hear about probiotic bacteria, right? Where it's all about, you know, we're hearing all about fermenting and everybody's into kombucha these days and, you know, getting that gut bacteria up, right? Because, you know, this huge gut brain connection, all this amazing stuff that we're learning about the bacteria inside of our digestive system. Well, inulin is one of the things that those bacteria really love to eat. So it's a food for the good gut bacteria. So, you know, not only are you getting all these vitamins and minerals, but now you're feeding your good gut bacteria as well, which everybody wants that, right? So it's not just about actually getting the physical bacteria in, it's about feeding them rather than, you know, the bad bacteria, which love sugars and, you know, all of that sort of stuff, right? So anyway, just a really interesting little thing about the burdock root there. And that seems to fall under these roots. So you got the burdock root, you got the chicory root, you got the dandelion root there. And I would suggest that it's under, you know, these other roots as well. I would imagine that the inulin is seems to be sort of a common factor between these different roots. So just a little extra goodness from your burdock root there. Okay, so but burdock, it seems to grow as a biannual, they call it. So first year, it creates this. The first year root is what you're going to want to get. This is, so anyway, okay, first year grows this basal rosette, they call it. So it's just these leaves on the ground. I'll point them out later. Second year, it's stored up all that energy in its root. Now it shoots up this and it creates this. And now it's producing its seed and it wants to spread. And I'm going to help it here by, you know, just tossing some seeds around. So next year, hopefully there's more burdock plants growing here in the spring. And now it's basically done. So you dig that up, the root's nothing. You don't want to eat that root. This plant's basically dead. It's done its job. It's spreading its seed. It's, you know, creating abundance for the future for all of us. Imagine how many burdock plants you could grow from here. There's like, you know, 50 seeds in each one of these little things, right? Just totally amazing, right? So seed is what you get from this, but that's a nice way to find other burdock plants. But of course, as I say that, I don't see any right around this one. So this probably came in from somewhere else, and it's its first year growing here, and it hasn't actually put any seed down. But I've seen to that, that'll change. Next spring, you'll probably find a bunch of burdock plants there. But I do know that over here is the sort of that big old rosette that I mentioned right here. I want to harvest the burdock for you. Inside all of these magnificent berry bushes here. So inside here, so a little bit of, there's a couple different things here. So we see a lot of comfrey here. Another, this is a plant, you know, it's definitely different from the burdock. So here's the burdock though, this down in here. So you can see it almost looks a little bit like rhubarb. It's not as shiny. It's very soft on the leaves. You see there's a few of them around here.